Hi everyone, and welcome to the second episode of Danny's Garden Railway. The Garden Railway is still a far off project, but I want to show you today how I make a non-DCC ready locomotive from Bachmann into DCC, because the whole track will be run on DCC and Hornby 00 gauge live steam, but I come to that on a later stage. Anyway, these are two Bachmann locomotives. One is in the Southern livery, and the other is in the British Rail livery. Let me turn it in the reflection here. Anyway, I already started work on these two. These non-DCC Bachmann locomotives are a real nightmare to turn into a DCC locomotive. Let me show you what the problem is. So here we took the Southern livery apart. Both locomotives are the same in build. Only this chassis and delivery itself difference from each other, but the mechanism inside is completely the same. So what is the problem with the Bachmann locomotives? Well, as you can see, I already started work on this, but anyway, there is very little space inside the locomotive to build in a DCC decoder. So you must cut and file away some space to put in your DCC decoder. And also it involves some wiring and some drilling. And let me explain you why. A Bachmann locomotive actually exists out of two big components. These are two halves, and you see the cable is here in the middle, but actually it's split open, and it takes the currency from one side and just take the currency of the other side. So the motor here you can see the split very well. The motor takes the electricity in DCC form, of course, from this side and from this side. But for to turn it into DCC, we must disconnect the motor from the chassis. That's the first problem. And the second problem is we need to make space to put in the DCC decoder. So what I did is I took a metal saw, saw out a corner into the locomotive, file it out nicely so a DCC decoder can fit in very nice, and I disconnected the connections to the motor. I soldered on two cables, isolating them with this shrinking rubber thing, and then I put the cables to the front where the decoder is going to be. The decoder, to connect the decoder to the track or to the currency of the track, I drilled in two holes on the front and put in some wire to put in some screws, so I can make a very good connection that come out from the screws to the decoder, and from the decoder, which will go, you see these cables are still loose, which will be connected to these cables, and then the DCC signal will be sent to the motor. As you can see, it involves a little bit more than just soldering on a DCC decoder. So next stage will be putting in the DCC decoder. So today the Lais decoder arrived. Lais is new to me.
I heard good stuff about it. It's like one of the cheapest decorers you can get now on the market. If you go to Jennifer Case blog, you will see that she does a review on them. You can get them in 21 pins, 18 pins, 6 pins, but I took the one without the pins because I'm going to solder it straight away, and if it comes to an 8 pin this one, and I would have cut the 8 pins away anyway, so there is no point in ordering one with 8 pins. If you order them on the internet, the sellers sell them at almost the same price everywhere in Europe. But depending on where you live, you can look at the shipment. Maybe it's something that is closer to you where the shipment is cheaper, or they do a bulk shipment. You have to sort it out. But anyway, these are one of these cheap ones, and I'm going to test them. I'm going to put them in today. So what I need is to solder them in. I'm not going to bother you with the soldering itself. There is enough stuff to find here on YouTube and the rest of the internet about soldering. I use some double tape, one of these foamy ones, to stick the decoder into place. What I also did was put in some plastic card just as some isolation from the rest of the metal. I'm going to put this in and solder it in. I got a small schematic with the decoder explaining which color goes to where. There are obvious some cables that are intended for lights in the locomotive, but since this is a steamer and doesn't have any lights, so these are not going to be used. The only ones I'm going to use are red black, which comes from the track itself, or from the track to the locomotive, and these I will take from here where the screws are. And then the orange and gray one goes on to the motor, and yeah, that's about it. It's as simple as that. Okay, we're back. As you can see, a DCC decoder has been fitted, but unfortunately I haven't filmed me swearing, because this brand new Lais decoder has already gone to DCC heaven. And it's not due to that it's a cheap decoder, but it's due to my own fault. I had still had a shortcut in the locomotive. And like I said before, the problem was these contacts here from the motor, where it's normally making contact on the normal DCC, on the normal DC running, it makes contact to these sides here, and it takes the currency coming from the track to the wheels up onto one part of the chassis, and from this side to this part of the chassis onto the motor. Now, to enable it to run on DCC, you must disconnect these two and also put these wires to your DCC decoder. But there was a it still made it contact somewhere, and from the moment I turned on my DCC decoder to test it on the track, it immediately blew up. But no, I found an old Hornby 8 pin that I still had lying around, so I've used that
instead. And what I've done now to make sure there isn't any shortcut anymore, I made the hole bigger here, filed it out, so there is no way of it contacted anymore to the motor. So if you want to do this, make sure that there is enough space between the contact of the motor and the chassis itself. So as you can see, the DCC decoder sits nice, tucked away. It's all clean. Now I'm going to put the housing over it, and I will show you on a later stage it running on a piece of track. So here we are on a very short piece of track, just to show you that it works, and here we go. As you can see, I can let it go as a very slow runner. This is only on 2. Going into reverse. Yeah. One very difficult Bachmann non-DCC ready locomotive turned into DCC running locomotive. Thanks for watching. Bye.